Hey, Bart here with a quick one today. I think science has a problem. It's not a huge problem, and other areas of study have it too. But because I make videos about science, I come across it all the time. I think that there are some really annoying words and terminology that we use when describing science in English, because people who aren't sciency end up regularly interpreting them differently to how scientists do. Often, this is because of how language works or how it changes over time, which I find super interesting. A really good example of this is the word theory. In science speak, the word theory refers to some explanation of natural phenomena that has been repeatedly tested using a rigorous process known as the scientific method. In other words, a theory only becomes a theory once it's got a lot of supporting evidence to back it up. But in everyday colloquial use, the meaning of the word theory more closely matches what scientists call a hypothesis. Most people think of a theory as a hunch or a guess made to explain something. That doesn't necessarily mean that the non-scientists are wrong, by the way. They're just using the word in a different way, which is perfectly valid. The risk comes in when the two definitions mix up, though. Somebody saying gravity is just a theory, for example, thinks that even scientists think of Newton's theory of gravitation as just a guess, when in reality its premises and predictions have been tested very thoroughly, and it's not just a hunch. Another example of scientific words meaning different things to different people is the word instantaneous. Over time, as language has changed, most people think of the word instantaneously to mean the same thing as instantly, or right away. There was an instantaneous change in his facial expression. That was a bit dramatic. I don't know why, it's the best example I could think of. But physicists use the word instantaneous to mean something very slightly different. In physics, instantaneous means in an instant of time, or happening over a very short period of time, an instant. It doesn't have to necessarily be the next instant in time. It doesn't have to be right away, but rather just an instant in time. There are also a couple of terms related to energy that are a bit of a pet peeve of mine. This is because the physics version of energy is a difficult concept to understand. Even the word energy itself has a wide variety of uses depending on whom you ask, ranging from being a mathematical concept we use to solve problems, to the stuff we generate in power stations, to a description of how someone is feeling positive or negative energy. But these are not all the same, despite some people maybe trying quite hard to convince you that they are. The first of these energy terms I want to chat about is free energy. I've got a full video about this on the channel already, so check it out up here if you're interested. I'll also leave a link in the description. But basically, free energy is a measure of how much useful energy is available in a system that we're studying. For example, pushing a box or bowling a cricket ball, as opposed to the energy that would be wasted as heat. But people could easily hear the term free energy and think that it refers to energy you can create from nothing or get for free, which totally goes against the law of conservation of energy. And that's the other energy term I wanted to talk about, conservation of energy. In physics, this usually refers to the idea that energy is neither created nor destroyed, simply transferred from one form to another. In other words, for a closed system, the energy is conserved, or the total energy doesn't change over time, even if the types of energy in the system change from one to another. But the word conserve, outside of the physics world, means to protect or to save, or to prevent wasteful use of something. Like in animal conservation, which is a way to protect animals at risk of extinction. And I've genuinely heard people say energy is conserved as a way to convince someone else not to bother arguing with someone, because they're not worth the energy spent on the argument. Now remember, none of these differences in meaning should be a way for us science fans to look down on people who aren't sciencey. If anything, it's on us to clarify what they mean to us and accept that they might mean different things outside of our science bubble. Because that is how language works. And if we don't accept it, then this makes misinformation much easier to spread by people who accidentally or deliberately play on people's different understandings of these ideas. With that being said, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the thumbs up button and subscribe for more fun physics content. Hit the bell button to be notified every time I upload as well. A huge thanks to all of my Giga patrons and all the others over on my Patreon page. I'll leave a link to my Patreon in the description if you'd like to support me on there. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you very soon.